Guys, the sun is shining. It's time to get outside and it's time to go climbing. I got the car packed. I'm ready to go. Mallory, come on, let's go. The sun is shining. The weather is perfect, perfect conditions. Let's go climbing. Let's go. Get in the car.
Courtney, COVID.
COVID. Let's go back inside. All right, back inside. Cart's unpacked, all the gear's everywhere. So we're gonna salvage something and try and get something done here. How about a rundown of all the essential gear that you need to go sport climbing? Yeah, let's get into it. Let's go. Parker likes the idea of the gear rundown, don't you? Yeah, that's a yes. All right, let's get into the essential gear that you need to go sport climbing. And we're gonna talk about gear and gear only. It's obvious to say that you need a harness, shoes, chalk bag, and chalk. So we're gonna skip those. We're gonna get right into the gear, the hardware. That's the good stuff. That's what also gearheads are all in love with and really love to research and check out. So I'm gonna run down the essential gear that you need and I'm gonna give you how much it costs. So you know how much more poor you're gonna be after purchasing all of these things. So let's get started with it. First up to chat about is ropey. The rope is your lifeline. This bad boy right here is going to be what keeps you from falling as you climb up the rock. When you are sport climbing, you are bringing this bad boy up with you. It's not already at the top like it is during top roping. You are going to want a dynamic rope, not a static one. Dynamic means that it has some give in it. And static does not. And static will break your back if you fall on that. Whereas dynamic will catch you nicely. Dynamic ropes for sport climbing, you're gonna want something that is 9.x millimeter range. So anything from 9.0 to 9.9. This rope here is a 9.9 and it's 40 meters long. This is my gym rope. You're not gonna need anything more really than 40 meters for most gyms. Double check with your gym if this is something that you want to get into there, and they will tell you what you would need there. And this bad boy here cost me $125. This is the Black Diamond gym rope. For outdoor climbing, I have a completely different rope. I have a Beal 9.7, and that one was a little bit more of a pretty penny. Ropes will typically cost you anywhere between $130 to an upwards of $400. The price difference is going to be dependent on how long the rope is. You can get all the way down to like a 30 meter rope, 20 or 30 meters for a gym, and then all the way upwards to an 80 meter rope. My outdoor rope is 70 meters long, and that is a really good length for a variety of different style climbing. And then the other difference for the price range is going to be if it is dry or non-dry treated rope. I have a non-dry rope because it is, one, cheaper. You're gonna find out through this video that I'm kind of cheap. And number two, I'm a fair weather climber. I don't do ice climbing. I don't climb in the rain. I don't do any of that stuff. So I don't really need a dry treatment rope. But that's where that big price range comes from, is diameter. Typically, kind of with sport climbing ropes, the smaller you get in diameter, you get into that like 9.2 range or a little bit lower than that, the ropes are gonna be more expensive. If you stay in that like 9.7 to 9.9 range, they'll be a little bit more fairly priced. So again, you're looking at anywhere between $130 to $400 on your rope. Sounds like a lot, but at the end of the day, it's your life. And I think your life's probably worth more than that, right? All right, next up for gear is what your rope goes into for the belayer. And that is a belay device. There are a couple different types of belay devices, some that have assisted braking and some that are just an ATC where there isn't an assist there. Either way, they're gonna put friction onto the rope and help your climber be caught when they fall instead of falling to the ground. The ones that I use most of the time is the Grigri. This is the Petzl Grigri. It is on the expensive side, far as belay devices go. This one is just the Grigri, not the Grigri Plus. This one's $150. Most gyms will demand that you use an assisted braking device, and the most common one is this one. So some gyms will require this, mine does, and maybe yours does too. So double check on that before you throw all your money into one of these. A cheaper option to go with is an ATC device. Again, this is not an assisted braking device. This is pretty simple. Your rope goes in here, a carabiner goes through, and that's what stops the rope when it gets pulled. These ones are gonna be a lot cheaper, and they're gonna range between $20 to $40. This one here was a $40 one. This is the Petzl Reverso. So that is another type of belay device. All right, next up is draws. This is what your climber is going to put the rope into on the way up the route. You can get a bunch of different styles of draws. These ones have bent gates in them. You can get wired gate ones. These ones have a really thick dog bone in the center of them. These are the Petzl Spirit Express draws. Now, they are a little bit more expensive, but I totally got them because my benefits covered them at work, not because I'm rich. My wife is looking at me like, what? You can create your own just by purchasing a dog bone or a sling for in between and then a couple of different carabiners on the ends. However, pre-made ones are typically going to range from $20 to $35. They'll also differ in price if they are shorter, which this one is a shorter one, or if they are longer. This one's a little bit of a longer one. And they also range in price depending on what type of carabiners they have on the ends and what type of dog bone you have in the center. So all different reasons why they may range in price, but a quick draw is definitely a must-have in sport climbing. You clip this into the wall and then you put your rope into it and it goes through and saves you, again, when you fall. Next up, we got carabiners. We got lots of locking carabiners. You need one of them for sure for your belay device. I have this one here. It's nothing too fancy. I honestly don't even love it that much. I just have it because it has like a nice, easy way to clip with a ball that you push in and clip. I love the sound of, I shouldn't say, I should bleep that out. Freaking love the sound of clipping things. Oh, listen, listen. Oh, that makes me want to climb. However, I got a bunch of these ones here. The reason being is for when you get to the top and you want to perhaps clean everything off that you've placed, like all of your quick draws that you've placed on the wall, you're going to want to lock yourself in or create an anchor for your buddies to top rope after you have shown how skilled you are with your lead climbing abilities. You might want to create a top rope anchor at the anchor station. So you'll need some of these locking carabiners. This one here is just a screw gate, and I do prefer these ones. They're come in a pack of three. They're Black Diamond Positron, or their newer ones are called Hot Forge, I believe. And they come in a pack of three for $35. But if you purchase them individually, they typically range between $12 all the way up to $35 a piece, just depending on what kind of technology you have. These screw gate ones are really easy. They just spin and lock the gate. Boom, now it's locked. And then you unspin it, and now we're open and ready to go. Cool. All right, so speaking of creating anchors and locking carabiners, something that goes alongside with that is slings. Slings are basically nylon webbing that are in a big loop. You can get pre-made ones like this where they're already sewn together, or you can get them by the roll and then tie a knot in it. That way you can get as much as you want or as little as you want, and then you tie a really cool knot in the end of it and you're set. Something that's pre-made like these ones are typically $10 to $20 depending on how big they are. If you're going to buy it by the meter, you can get rolls from somewhere like Mech for about $2 a meter. There's also something called a daisy chain. I don't really use a daisy chain, but they are cool and they're easy to use. They're essentially rings of nylon webbing all together so that you can easily attach yourself to an anchor point and clean things off. Those typically range from 20 to 50 bucks depending on which ones you want. But yeah, I don't really use a daisy chain, but a lot of people do. Last, but certainly not least, is a helmet. I always use a helmet when I am sport climbing outdoors. This is an absolute must for me. I have a tendency to clock my head off of things, and if there is any type of, you know, debris that falls from overhead, you will want this as well. If you take a nasty whipper and you flip around because you had your leg stuck under the rope, you could bash your head against the the rock face as well. And that wouldn't be pleasant without. It wouldn't be pleasant regardless, but it would be more unpleasant without one of these. This is the Black Diamond Half Dome. It's about $75, but helmets can range, you know, really anywhere from $70 to an upwards of $190, just depending on, you know, what you're looking for in your helmet. For me, it is a must have, and I would highly, highly, highly recommend that anybody who goes outdoor climbing definitely use one of those. Nothing is worse than smacking your head. All right, and a little bonus item, depending on how long your day is and how much you're belaying, you might want belay gloves. These ones are just easy peasy, half finger, so you still have that like nice feeling of touch sensitivity in the front of your fingers, but you're getting that protection from the dirt and rope burn of just belaying all day and getting your skin all roughed up. So belay gloves is another. It's not a must have, it's not an essential, but it's a nice to have for sure. And belay gloves, I think these ones cost me around $30. Typically they are made out of leather on the palm spot here. There's typically real leather there. I'm sure you can find non-leather ones if you are, you know, of the vegan variety. All right guys, that is pretty much all the essential gear that you are going to need to sport climb outdoors, other than, of course, you're gonna want your shoes and your harness and your chalk and chalk bag. If you're gonna be doing indoor lead climbing, all you really need, again, is those three essentials I just mentioned, plus a rope and a gree-gree or any other type of belay device that's assisted braking. That's typically what gyms will want. If you are in a gym that will accept an ATC, good for you, because that's a hell of a lot less money to spend. All right, guys, I hope that you enjoyed learning a little something about the hardware that you need, the gear that you need to go sport climbing outdoors. If you have any questions, pop them in the comments below. I'll be happy to try and answer them for you. I'll also have some hyperlinks in the description below for all of this gear. Please keep in mind that everything that I talked about for pricing wise is in Canadian funds, as I am a Canuck. All this stuff I got from Mountain Equipment Co-op, so the mech.ca links will be below for you to check this stuff out. I kept it pretty surface on what these things do. It was just more about a listing of what gear you need and how much it's gonna cost you. So if you do want a deep dive on any of the gear that I mentioned today, just throw a comment in below and I will take that into consideration and create a video for a deep dive on how these things work. I really appreciate you joining the channel today and watching this. Join me again on Thursday and I will see you then. As always, like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell as well. I'm down for that. So I will see you next Thursday. All right, everyone. Ciao.